In part 29, Pokemon White version, Line did Nuzlocking challenge of doom and destruction and sadness. We're gonna start off by doing some massive grinding. Last video, by the way, I took a nap and ended up to be going to sleep between last video and this video because I'm super lazy and that's a little bit too dark. Last video we unlocked, essentially for us, Route 10 for auto grinding, so we're gonna be doing some of that. And several other kinds of grinding too. I think we're going to try to EV train Tom a little bit. He hasn't been with us as long as Sally had been, so maybe Sally just had max EVs. That's a possibility. Actually, let's go check that right now. Let's get Sally out of the PC. We are in Opelicid City, which is close. It's just the best proximity to Route 9, which is where the department store is in this game. Let's see, let's take Sally and put her in. We'll take Atmo out temporarily. Yeah, we're also going to be catching some guys in this video. Probably in Mistralton Cave. Although, I plan currently to have about half this video be grinding, so... Oh! Winter! Okay! First time we've seen the season be different. The trees are a little bit greener, like evergreen, I guess. Instead of, some stuff. I was informed by A180, so, I mean, I didn't know if it was going to change or not. Wow, this means we could have gotten some other Pokemon, right? Let's see. Oh, we did not go into the Moor of Osiris. You know what? Screw it. I'm just going to call it the Moor of Osiris. I don't care. Anyway, we look at the area for Vanillite. In winter, we can actually get Vanillite in Dragon Spiral Tower. I didn't know that. Oh, wait, that's because it's in winter. Yeah, in every other season, only cold storage. But in winter, we could have gotten Vanillite in Dragon Spiral Tower and Route 6. You guys can see sort of that on the top screen here. Okay, what about Vanillish? Can we get Vanillish somewhere else? No, we can get Vanillish in the winter in the Dragon Spiral Tower. I think there's some other guys that we can get expanded stuff for in the winter. Like, how about Deerling? Deerling's not any different. Now, there's some guys who vary their appearances based on season, so kind of an expansion to the time of day is that in Kubchu. Is Kubchu any different? In winter they come out of just the cave. But unfortunately, we already passed those areas where we could have gotten some of these other ice-type guys. So, yeah, Beartick also. Cryogonal also appears in the... Hey there, winter. In winter, Shelmet does not appear. So we would have probably gotten someone else, I guess. Stunfisk, winter, yeah. So it's winter now, and so things are gonna be a little bit different. Drudagon has the option that, like, he appears in different places, but I don't see any place he appears besides Dragon Spiral Tower. So, I don't wanna do that. Okay, so it's winter now. Winter. We're looking through the Pokédex and seeing if there's, like, new people that are gonna appear. Well, Stoutland can appear on Route 10 as well. We're just looking for guys that have winter displayed. Tranquil. Somewhere. Let's see. Winter. Yeah, in winter, Tranquil stop appearing as many places because they go south for the winter, I guess. That makes perfect sense. Palpitoad, not found during the winter. Okay. So, looks like, I guess that was good. I think Palpitoad and Shelmet were two guys that we could even get in Icerus City. So, I guess it's a good thing that we took down Icerus City in autumn. So that we could actually possibly get a guy there. So, that's cool. I'm pretty okay with that. It means we didn't get a chance for another ice type, but we did get an extra guy, and I think I'll take the extra guy over getting another ice type as opposed to something else. So, I think that looks like it. We start with Vanillite. Okay, so it looks like there's nothing too shattering for us. I think A180 mentioned, or someone mentioned, that in Icerus City. It's funny how I can say Icerus City, but I can't say more of... I can't say the more. I guess it's because of the of You know, there's an O in my mind for the of, and I think Osiris, but that's not it. So anyway, we're gonna hit Isira City. This isn't the right guy, right? No, this is the guy that sells Pokeballs. Okay, we're gonna get an iron up here. We're gonna get an iron. This is X-Attack guy, right? Oh, this is the correct guy. Okay, we're gonna buy an iron. And we're gonna see if we can use this on Sally, because I think her defenses are probably maxed out. Or actually, do we have one of these? No, we don't have the defense wing. Or feather, or whatever it's called. Oh, we actually already had an iron. That's okay. More iron is good. Okay, let's try to use this on Sally. No, it won't have any effect. So there's a pretty good chance that Sally, at least on her defenses, were pretty high up there. And most likely, I think, likely maxed out. Otherwise, that really, I mean, you know, that's only a test for if it's 100 or over. So, apparently, you know, it is. So, meh. Okay, whatever. In that case, then, let's start this video by going to Isira City. You guys saw it was autumn when the video started, right? I saw that correctly, right? And then when we walked outside, it's like, whoa, suddenly it's winter. So now we're in Isira City, and there's snow, which is good, I guess. That's better than rain, because rain makes it hard to see. So, I think there's supposed to be, like, snow drifts here, and we can, like, run on places. I hope this, like, didn't make Nuzlocke Cave inaccessible, like, the day after we were gonna go there. That would be pretty funny, actually. There's somebody to get down from here. Okay. Yeah, there's snow drifts. We can walk up here. I think we can go up here before. Oh, I bet that's how we get these items! Okay, yeah, let's go try to get this item. Turn the dowsing machine on. I bet that's how we get this item. There's still, like, a... Yeah, so all this down here was... Oh, it's ice. That makes sense. We slide on. Yeah, so no wild Pokemon encounters in here. Okay, so yeah, now we can... Yeah, now with the snow... With the snow, we can go around here. Yeah, we can walk down here. We can walk in here, right? Yes. Right here. Max potion. Okay, so not a very good item. Not crucial. But, so that's where that item finder was that we kept trying to find. And over here, a rare candy. Okay. So yeah, this is only accessible during the winter. So I don't know what caused it to be winter, if it was just because it's, well, today's April 1st. I wonder if that's what it is. Yesterday was March 31st, so that makes today April 1st. It's April Fool's Day, in real life, but it's going to be, like, April 2nd when this video goes up, I think. So I don't know if there's any new places or not. Let's see how this changed, this route, because this route had some of those puddles like that, too. Yeah, so this route... I'm curious as to how this is gonna affect more of the icy town, but I think we're gonna save that for a little bit later. What we're gonna do right now is fly back to the Felicid City. We're gonna auto grind on Route 10. I think we're gonna try to get Cooper to level. Here's my itinerary. We're gonna get Cooper to 50, level 50. Then I want to go and get some wings, feathers, and whatnot to rack up a little bit of cash that way safely, and then we're gonna come back and grind Justin up a little bit, and then probably finish with some more wings and stuff, because we want to get more money. Why do we want to get more money? Because more money means we can buy vitamins and stuff and EV train that way. We may also be EV training Tom a little bit at some point in there. Basically between actual grind sessions, we're gonna go get feathers. So let's put Sally up, and we're gonna take someone who's not weak to fighting. I kind of wish that... Well, actually, Fungus resists fighting because he's poison type. I was kind of hoping he'd be a bug. I don't know why. I guess because Parasect was. But anyway. Let's get... We haven't had Blair in a while. Let's have Blair. We haven't had Blair in the party for a while. So that leaves us with Cooper, Justin, Tom, Jake, Billy, Blair. Okay, cool. Okay, that's who... Oh, wait. Actually, I need Jason. That's right. Let's get Jason, then, because we need Jason. We can take out... Let's see, why do we have Justin? Yeah, we're going to take out... We're going to put Jason in for Justin. Okay. So, we're going to... I think that's only, like, two levels needed on Cooper. So, cool. We're going to save... Well, no, we're not going to save. Why do I think save? We're just gonna start the grind session. This should be a pretty long one. I'm gonna guesstimate to be about 10 minutes video time, so about 80 minutes real time or more, depending on whether I do times 8 or times 8 5 or times 8 times 0.5 or something like that. I don't know. Anyway, skip this if you don't want to watch a really long grind session. Okay guys, welcome for another mid-grind session, whatever the crap this is. Looks like I went a little bit too far, and there's an ace trainer up here who ambushed me. Wonderful. Okay. Breaks the mold! Does this fracture? That's just great. Let's see. Looks like it could be a dragon. Looks like this might be the evolved form of Axew, maybe, based on the color scheme. We have Lucky Egg on Cooper, and not Rindleberry, which makes me a little bit afraid. But we're gonna go for Blizzard. Dragon Claw, yeah, this looks like it's the evolved form of that guy. Okay, Cooper's gonna take physical hits really well. That did quite a bit though. Blizzard's gonna hit. Super effective damage. See how much this does. Okay, cool. One hit KO. If that had gotten close, I probably would have just used Aqua Jet. So I guess that's cool that we get some extra experience. Excelgar, what is this? Kind of a similar color scheme to Scolipede, but I don't know what this is. Looks like it could be a ghost type. Cooper doesn't have his Rindleberry, he's not safe. So, level 39 though, I don't know what this is. We're gonna go to our steel type, Jason, who's level 30, or 47. Whoa, flashlights are falling. Okay, so this is another one of these things. Giga Drain, very good thing that we switched out. That would have rolled over Cooper, especially without Rindleberry. So very good switch on my part. We're gonna use Gear Grind, me first. Is going to capture our Gear Grind, use it against us. However, Jason should take the hit pretty well. I think, yeah, he's gonna take it pretty well. Taking it really well, cool. Okay, yeah, we're gonna use Gear Grind, but we're gonna miss. I'm gonna keep using Gear Grind. If he wants to keep using me first, that's perfectly fine with me. We'll see if he can possibly miss too. He's not gonna miss this one though. But Gear Grind's not gonna do much to Jason. It's a pretty powerful move, but he resists it and he has good defense. So we're gonna have to heal up after this though. Gear Grind. This one's gonna hit. Hopefully we get a one-hit KO. This thing doesn't look like it's too sturdy. But that was quite a bit of HP that looked like was getting sent down. So one-hit KO with Gear Grind. Very good. Very good. Jason with experience. Let's see who the last guy is. Cooper level 49 with the had to stand. Electric. Okay, some sort of eel. Electric eel. We don't have possibly a water electric type, as it and eels are fishes. So this thing's pretty neat. Looks pretty cool. I like this thing. We have Blair, who resists electric and water. We're gonna go to Blair. Good thing we brought her, huh? And we don't have Jason, which is fine because, or not Jason, Justin, because he's probably weak to water. Discharge is gonna come, and hopefully not paralyze Blair. Cool, not very effective. We're just gonna use Leaf Blade, and this will help see if this thing is water type. No, it is not water type. Made the neutral sound. Acid, okay. Super effective acid, we were not expecting that. We're gonna use Leaf Blade though, because it should be a KO. So possibly Poison Electric, that would be a new type. It would be quad weak to ground, right? Yeah. I don't know, acid, I don't know. It doesn't seem like it'd be a poison type apart from just the way it used acid. So anyway. Okay, so we're gonna get healed up after that. Yeah, I'll probably put the skip annotation up right now, I guess. That would be a better option, because I think most people will want to watch that, because that was three new guys that I hadn't seen before. So, yeah, skip annotation, I guess, will be up now, rather than previously, so do that, and we'll see what music I pick for this lengthy grind session. Wow, I'm so glad I switched Cooper out there, because he didn't have his Rindleberry. Alright, skip now. Go do it. Do it now!
Big Apple, 3 a.m. Alley Cat Blues.
Hey guys, what's up? We are back now. Impromptu evolution. So we had theorized that Jason may evolve again based on the Pokedex. And now we're going to see what he evolves into. Maybe it's going to be two big gears. So clink, clang. And now let's see what his last form of evolution is going to be. Playing. So it looks like this thing, when it evolves, it just tacks more pieces onto it. Kind of like a Super Sentai Mecha. They just keep throwing more stuff on it and make it a cluster Megazord. So, okay, so now he's got a little spinning. He's got the red gear right here, little red horizontally laterally. I don't know. Anyway, parallel to the ground, as well as this other big spinning. I don't know what you want to call that, but anyway, that's what that is. So, clink clang. Let's see if the stats and stuff are similar. Jason now fully evolved to clink clang. Clink clang. Yeah, cool. Okay, so that's a decent naming scheme, I guess. Let's see if he's now on par with Cooper. Yeah, he's hitting up there on par with Cooper. I kind of wanted him to be level 50, but he's level 49 right now and he evolved, so I guess we'll say that's fine, because this grind session's gone on for like an hour and 20 minutes real time, and yeah, he's actually not that slow anymore. When he was clink, he was pretty slow, but now he's 91 speed, granted he's level 50. This volume is kind of like too loud, like the 3DS can get very loud. Okay, here's Billy level 42, has 94 speed, but yeah, he's actually not that slow. I thought he was going to be like really, really slow, but he's not that slow now. The evolutions really help him out. We still have Gear Grind. Yeah, attack power pretty much on par with Cooper. Both of them have plus attack nature. And yeah, that's with the minus speed nature. He still has 91. And special defense is a little bit better than Cooper's. Defense is not the Okay, so that worked out pretty well. Let's see what the Pokédex says about this guy. I think we should be close to there. Yeah, I was looking at to see if maybe this electric was some sort of a like a standalone thing around Tynamo, I don't know. But so yeah, let's look at the evolution states. I'm gonna extend my stylus so I can actually tap the touchscreen. Look at forms. Forms what we want, right? No, we want cry. That's what lets you guys see on the top screen. Yeah, clink to clang to cling clang. So yeah, you just have when he evolves once, it gets the big gear got tight on the back and takes away the face. I guess this one like rotates around. That's what happens there. And then just throw some more stuff on the bottom. So I kinda like how this thing goes. It just tacks more stuff onto him. It's a kinda unique evolution in that way, so possibly a little bit boring, but you know, I think it's pretty cool. Let's see what the Pokédex entry says about all three. Clink. And yeah, Clink Clang has the same height as Clang, which makes perfect sense because, you know, it's still the same thing. It's just got a little bit of stuff added that doesn't increase the height. Weight does increase, though. Let's see. Clink. Interlocking two bodies and spinning around generates the energy they need to live. Clang. Spinning mini gears are rotated at high speed and fired away repeatedly. It is dangerous if the gears don't return. And Clink Clang. The gear with the red core is rotated at high speed for a rapid energy charge. Okay, cool. So now we have another fully evolved guy. Another guy who can't use the Eviolite. But at least we were correct in assuming that he could use the Eviolite. We still theorize that Tom may evolve further. He's level 42 right now. So, what we did do with Tom... With Tom, we went pretty much the same way we did a couple videos ago with Sally and Billy a little bit. But since we haven't had Tom participate in as many battles as those two, I was hoping that, you know, he doesn't have anywhere near full EVs, so maybe he'll be a little bit more impressionable. And I don't think EVs get tacked on right away, you know, but we may be able to get him with the box trick. So let's check Tom's stats, and we're just going to use the box trick and see if that upgrades his stats, and if not, maybe we'll do a battle. Okay, so we've got 75, 87, 55. Remember that. 75, 87, 55. We're going to deposit Tom in the box. Pokemon. Okay, so we have what? 75. Gosh, I already forgot. 75. 75, 85, 55. Okay. Okay, now let's check him. 75. Okay, that's the thing we had before. So, I'm guessing that either. Now, I didn't check what his stats were before starting the grind session. I may actually have that somewhere on screen. I'll have to review the video and see if I... Because I think I may have pulled up his stats during the grind session. So there's a possibility of that. What we're going to do really quick, I guess, is get Tom up a level with an Audino. To see if the stats increase. And, yeah, I'm reasonably confident. Unless, like, EVs are like no longer around, which I'm pretty sure they aren't since we still have vitamins. If he doesn't get some sort of decent attack defense... gain and some other stuff here that I think... Okay, that's bothersome. We're going to use Repel to make sure we don't screw this up. I think we still have Jason at the top of the party, though. Let's put Tom at the top of the party because we want him to fight the Audino. And yeah, Audino, we saw a couple of things. Audino, level 36 anyway, has a Heal Pulse move, and this is a freaking stout one. We don't want to fight this. Do not want to fight it. Do not want it. We're going to go to Jason and then run away, I think. Or actually, we can probably just go to Jason and kill it. And that might give Tom enough level, enough experience anyway. But yeah, Audino has Heal Pulse, which heals the opponent. It's like present, except not having a chance to damage. So, okay. And yeah, as you can see, it's just our same Jason, he's just got a little ring around him now, which is kind of neat, nifty. His attack power's a lot higher, too, I guess because of those spikes. Pretty cool. But yeah, Heal Pulse heals the opponent. You know, obviously it's helpful to the player when fighting the wild guy, but I wonder if it's something like to knock people out of, not endure, like flail range and stuff. Anyway, we don't get very much defense and special attack increase, which makes me a little bit curious, because I know we fought quite a few guys. I'm wondering if the EVs, like, instantly get applied. Like, your stats can change without leveling up. I don't know, that's just a guess. Because I know we're sure as heck not getting very good, level ups after we do, you know, enough EV training that I think we should at least see more than plus 2. I mean, I know these guys aren't really level 100, so we're not going to see, you know, 4 EVs equals 1 extra stat point. We're not going to see that, but, you know, it's a little less than I would hope, so. And maybe it is just working properly, and I'm just not seeing the results because I'm not doing quite enough. You know, I don't really know what has changed, and if there's like a, if the cap is now 700 something, that would be pretty interesting, but probably pretty broken, as though that would, well, that would really help out walls for being mixed walls. But anyway, so I guess we're gonna start. Yeah, blurriness is now gone. Actually, what we're gonna do to make sure that something dumb doesn't happen, we're gonna cut the video right here and pick right back up, so we can split this into two files. Alright, we're back here. That was, just wanted to make sure I didn't mess up the file or, you know, forget to record audio or something dumb like that. So let's go in here. That biker's going really fast down there. There's a truck off to the side. I wonder if there's a Mew in there. Yeah, we're gonna go. One thing that we also did was we got quite a bit of feathers on the bridge. So we're gonna sell some of these feathers, see how much money we can get for these. We also picked up some gems. How much did gems sell for? Just 100. We also picked up a new kind of feather, actually two new kinds of feathers. One of which is the Pretty Wing, which only sells for like 100. Yeah, it sells for 100, and doesn't really do anything. I guess it said it was beautiful, so I was thinking maybe this is like a to sell item. There may be some like collector for these somewhere in the game that wants them and will give you like special items in exchange for them, is what I'm guessing. Otherwise, it's what is it used for? So that's just my guess. We finally picked up the special attack feather, the Genius Wing. So, I think that means we've now seen... Whoa, whack the camera with my thumb as I'm getting a drink of water. Okay, there we go. We're going to sell all but one, I think, of each feather. Just so that we can have them. Muscle Wing. Yeah, we got 9 Muscle Wings. Very good. Very good. And we also got some stuff from the athletes. We're probably going to go find some more athletes this video. We got a lot of Swift Wings, too. Okay, cool. That was a good chunk of money that we made. Let's go buy... Oh, actually, this is the guy we want to talk to. We want to buy vitamins. Yeah, we have a lot of money. We have 100 grand. Wow. Okay, we're going to buy... We're going to buy zinc. This is the first one we're going to buy. We're going to buy... We're going to buy 5 zinc. That's a pretty significant chunk of our money. But we're going to use some zincs on some guys. Primarily... yeah, here we go. Here's our zincs. Zinc. We're going to use zinc on Cooper. Okay, Cooper is now maxed out special defense. He now has 100 special defense EVs. I didn't check what his special defense was before, though. So I don't know exactly how much it increased it by, but let's see how it compares to, let's see, 77. If that's an increase, it's probably a very minor point increase. But usually when you use the vitamins, it ends up to also increase your, you know, it increases the stat right away. We're gonna use this on Jason. Okay, that was our last thing. We're gonna buy some iron, because I think Jason's probably gonna have to take some dragon hits for us from Dragon Claw and stuff. So I want a couple of iron. That's kind of ironic since, you know, it's an iron steel type anyway. Okay, we're gonna buy 4 iron, and we already have 2. We're gonna use all these on Jason right now, because we want him to have really, really good defense. Where's our irons? Irons. We also have some protein. Let's use our protein as well. Protein, we're going to use on... we're going to save that for someone else, I think. We're going to save protein for someone else. Iron. Let's use iron on Jason. Raises defense. Okay, that was all our iron. So, plus 60 defense EVs to Jason. We're going to see HP ups to go on someone. Let's use this on... Who needs some more HP? I'm trying to look and see. Usually, ghost types have pretty bad HP. So, let's use these on Tom. Okay, that gave him 2 more max HP, so that's cool. Okay, I think that's all of our vitamins right now. How much money do we have left? Because we can buy Maybe we should buy some more iron or something. Or is there something else we want? I'm only gonna buy iron, zinc, and HP up because I only care about the defensive stats in a Nuzlocke. So that's what we're gonna do with that. Let's buy three of these. That's the last one we're gonna buy because that gets us down pretty low. And I want to have some money to spend on. You know what we still didn't do? We still didn't buy fresh waters. But we have 32. That should be enough for what we're gonna do this video. So let's use this zinc. We're gonna use it on Tom because I know Tom doesn't have really good special defense right now. He's better on physical defense. Part of that is due to relaxed nature, which it turns out he's actually not that slow. I mean, his speed is now higher than his special defense. I don't think that was the case for when he was a Litwick. But yeah, 56, that's his lowest, well actually attack is his lowest stat. But 56 is that. So we're going to use these three irons, or three zincs. And we're going to see how high special defense can go. From 56. 56 to 59. Okay, so that's plus 3. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. I'll take that for sure. Yeah, and that makes sense, because that's, you know, around level 50, it would be, you know, approximately 8 EVs for plus 1 point. So, you know, those give 10, and we're a little under level 50, so that makes sense. Alright, cool. Okay, so that's our EV training for this video. Where else are we going to go to this, video? Let's see, just the start of the new file. First place we're going to go, I think, is back here, because I'm anxious to explore the, where is this cave? This cave, whatever it is. The cave of, not Mr. Alton Cave. Wellspring Cave. Yeah, I want to explore this. We're going to set up a party first, though, because we don't want to encounter people in here that can trump our whole party. We're going to try to roll with a party that is actually capable of dealing with, you know, girder and things like that. I don't want all of our crap weak to two types. You know, I don't want something with two coverage moves to be able to be super effective to my entire team. I don't want that. So let's move dudes around. And then I'll deal with items and stuff later. Plus the current party. And hopefully we got Tasha and Harte, I think it was, some levels too. I may put Violet in the thing though. Okay, we don't need Atmo. We only use Atmo for catching guys, but we will be catching some guys this video, I think. Let's see, Lampent, Tom. Yeah, I kind of want Tom. I need to make sure to take the Macho Brace off of him, so we don't screw up like we did with Billy. By the way, Billy almost got killed, because there was a sock that we encountered. It used counter. Like, I used fly, flew up, and then counter. I was like, oh no, if Billy doesn't kill this thing, because I know it has a lot of HP. Its defense maybe isn't that good, but it's got a lot of HP. It's, like, gonna counter and kill Billy. And thankfully, Billy got the one-hit KO. I'm also a little bit afraid of Wild Sock and Throw because of their outfits having, like, random focus sashes. I mean, heck, we saw a wild dude with Black Sludge last video. So, you know, maybe some wild Pokemon are gonna have some crazy held items. Let's see. Fighting and Rock is our big threat from Girder. And I think Blair is sufficient for that. How about Fire? The main three types I'm concerned about are Fire, Fighting, and Rock. Firefighting is resisted by Tom. Jake also is neutral to resist Rock and is neutral to the other two, although Special Defense is not that good. Cooper can take on Rock and Fire, no problem. Has a little bit of trouble with fighting, but Solid Rock helps there, and he's level freaking 50. Billy handles fire and fighting pretty well, just like Tom does, but he's also weak to rock. And then we have Kling Klang is weak to fire and fighting, resistant to rock. So these two form a pretty good switch in and out combination. And let's see, Aaron is going to be fight weak. And she doesn't help us. Actually, she resists rock, but we already have enough rock. Well, we have this guy who is resistant to rock. We already have two rock resists. And Justin, I don't really trust to take hits that well anyway. He's also weak to fighting. I mean, we have this guy who's. Let's see. What about fighting and fire? Fighting and fire, we can handle with Tom. Fighting and rock. We don't have someone who resists both those, but we have these two who are neutral to them, so I guess that's okay. And that leaves. Rock fighting, I guess. Rock fighting. Rock and fighting. I guess mainly girder. And those are usually physical ones, so girder is probably okay against that one, too. Okay, I guess this is a decent enough team. I don't really like having two water types in the same team, but, you know, one of them is our hero character, Cooper, and one of them is our fly surf guy, Billy, who has proved to be a valuable member of the team. He's gotten us out of a lot of jams, so that leaves main team member Sally. Sally, by the way, I'm pretty sure we will be taking to the Elite Four, because I'm just mortally afraid of a fighting type user in the Elite Four, and Sally can handle that okay. So we're taking Sally to the Elite Four, I know that. I know we're taking Cooper, I know we're taking Jason, because Jason just has so many resistances, Steel type is amazing, and likely Blair. So there's kind of two floating spots that I don't know who's going to fill in. There's likely Aaron and Justin will fill those spots. I consider that to be our main six. Justin, Aaron, Sally, Cooper, Jason, and Blair. With Tom, Jake, Billy, and Kathy now. Kathy was in the main team, but I think she's going to be kind of relegated to the secondary team. Just because, you know, I don't really like Unpheasant. I like Pitov, but the higher evolved forms are... They're okay, but I don't like them quite as much. They're not as cute as Pitov. But still a really good guy, just we have better guys that we can use. Workup is pretty nice, though. And then down here on the second tier, we're going to put Minkino down here. Wait, who do we have? Partey's right here. I can't remember who else we have in the daycare with... we have Rupert. Yeah, Rupert. Okay, we're going to put Violet down here on this row. And Atmo is sort of in our secondary team, but he has a special role. He's just our catcher guy. So, which is an important role, but, you know, we're not going to use him for battling. So we have... That's kind of our team structure, I guess, right now. We have our core six, and then we have a secondary set of about four guys that we can go to. Should one of our main six go down, we have guys we can go to for backup. And, of course, we're keeping our reserves trained up, too, with the daycare. So let's get healed up, and I'm pretty decently confident in this team that we can handle whatever is in the... What is this the cave called? It's the cave where we caught Sally. Wellspring Cave, that's it. I had to think for a minute. Let's get our items set up first, though. Because we want to make sure we have the correct items on people. And no one in the PC has anything, so let's just... Delegate items as need be. Okay, Tom. Tom's gonna have the spell tag. These should all be in here. I don't know. Tom might be able to use the Eviolite. And actually, yeah, we're gonna put the Eviolite on him, because I think he can evolve again. He doesn't look like he's fully evolved. He looks like he could evolve again just by appearances. Okay, Cooper with Rindo, Jake with the Rocky Helmet, Jason needs something else. Billy, I think, has the Sharp Beak, which is his correct item. Blair, we're going to give Blair the... let's give Blair the Miracle Seed, because that'll increase the damage from her Leaf Blade as well. Big Root is tempting. I would probably put Big Root on there for a boss battle or something, and I think I passed Miracle Seed. Yeah, there we go. I was trying to look for the sprite. Jason is gonna get... No longer can he use the Eviolite. Magnet might be okay. Expert Belt. No. No. Bloodstone. No, it's silly. What do we want on him? Bright Powder is sort of the default item. I mean, it's extra evasion when you can't use the Eviolite, so that's cool. We have Tom at Eviolite, Cooper at Rindo, Jake at Rocky Helmet, Jason at Bright Powder, Blair at Miracle Seed, and Billy at Sharp Beak. Good. Everyone has correct items. Good items. Let's go. Let's go. Because this video, we need to do something in this video besides grind. So, yeah, that was likely... Probably 20 minute or so grind session at least. Let's see how high level our guys are since we're right here in front of the daycare. Well, actually, we can't check because we have a full party, so whatever. Anyway, I don't think those two were in the same egg group, so they weren't going to breed. I'm guessing that the trash bag is in the amorphous egg group, which means it can breed with Gardevoir, which is bad, I guess. But anyway, I'm going to throw on a repel for the first area here anyway. For the first little bit. We're going to throw on a super repel just because that's what my cursor's at. And yeah, we encountered one of the dark spots in the water, and it was the Bloody Basculin, like level 9 or some crap. It was like lower level than the things I was encountering in here anyway. Here's an elixir. I don't even know if there's more to this cave necessarily. I just know that we can surf across, and ideally there's, you know, more than just a few items. I'll turn the dowsing machine on. Yeah, there's hidden items, definitely right here probably. Can we get up here? Can we get up here? There we go. Circle pad, fail. PP up, very good. Very good item. Okay, cool. I want the PP up. There's another hidden item off to the right. Steer this swan over here. Oh, how did I miss this one before? Full heal. Okay, well that's not too important, I guess. I need to buy some more awakenings, by the way. Because they are a little bit cheaper than full heal. Okay, we can land here, but there's no point in doing so. Yeah, there's some stairs right there, so we can go further down here. We're just keeping the wild guys away while we're on this top floor, pretty much. Okay, there's an item. Let's see what this is. Escape rope. Okay, we may need that, because I don't have Justin with me to dig. Although, I think we already had a couple escape ropes anyway. Okay, let's go down to the second floor. Oh, and there it's Flash. We need Flash. Let's see if anyone can learn Flash and get rid of like a TM move or something. I can relearn them later. Flash is, I think, TM70 in the previous generation. And yeah, still TM70. Let's see if anyone can learn Flash. Probably Tom can, right? Yeah, I was gonna say, surely the freaking lantern can learn Flash. I don't think any of Blair's moves are relearnable, right? No, I don't think so. Leaf Blade, no, I don't think so. Because Giga Drain's no longer a team. We're going to teach our Lantern Flash, which makes perfect sense. And what are we going to get rid of? None of his moves are really... None of his current moves are TM moves. I don't really want to get rid of Hex. Confuse Ray is probably what I'd rather get rid of, but... You know, because I want to keep a Ghost move. I mean, I want this moveset to stay the same, but just for the sake of this video, I need to get rid of something. I guess we'll get rid of Inferno for right now, as it has the lowest PP. We may relearn that later. But right now, we're going to teach him Flash, so that he can light this place up for us, because we've never explored this place before, and I'd rather have Flash on. Well, if this was my couple more times through the game, it might be okay. But anyway, okay, yeah, much bigger area. We can get through. We need to turn the dowsing machine on at all times. Two rows, Shadow Word Pain, Warlock Curses, all that. Here we go. There's an item. Max Potion, okay. Another thing we can't buy, but we can buy. Oh, there's a dig, or a dude, whatever it's called. We want to throw on a repel of some sort. Get up there. Go. There we go. Okay, normal repel. We're just gonna throw normal. Oh, okay, we still have repel on. Never mind. I think that's... Yeah, that's the other way around. I don't know if that's gonna stay or not. Let's use... No, not Pokemon. Repel. Because it may go away because we're taking a long time to get to it, and we're gonna have to surf. So, we're gonna throw a repel up anyway, though. Get around to it as quickly as possible. Okay, cool. Here we go. We get an electric gem. I think we already had a few of these. There's an item here. Let's see what this is. TM47, low sweep. Low sweep. Named similarly to low kick. We learned a little bit about this earlier. Let's see. It's a fighting type move. Let's see if it's pretty powerful. Probably not. I can't remember what number it was. 60 something, was it? No. Freshman, no. Oh, there we go. Low sweep. I knew it had a 7 in there somewhere. Okay, 60 power. Tax the target's leg, swiftly reducing the target's speed. Oh, okay. That's pretty nice. So it's similar to Icy Wind, that type deal. A little bit less power, a little bit more accuracy. And if Hitmontop learns that, I'm totally going to have that on Technician Top Man, because that'll be pretty freaking sweet. You know, reducing something speed as it comes in, and then maybe Hitmontop can outspeed it. So, you know, and Technician on the 60 power. Pretty nice. Pretty nice. Definitely, I think we'll have some sort of application. There's a bubbly spot somewhere. We're gonna find where the spot is. I don't see it on that side. We're gonna go back on this side. Probably just another bloody basculin or something. Yeah, here we go. Let's see what's in here. Yeah, it's just another basket. Level 7. Is that all? Is that the best you can do? Really? I don't know what the if there's like any higher level guys down here, since this is inaccessible before Surf. And there's some enemy fighting trainers up here. Okay, we're gonna see a wild fight in here. See if this is higher level or not. It's a Wubat, and it's level... Okay, it's level 10, so we're just gonna keep repels on in here. There's no point in fighting all these things. We already killed like a million of these things over the past few videos, although I guess if we did, then our EVs would have been maxed out, so maybe we actually didn't. Let's find our super repels then, which should be at the bloody top of the screen, but they're like not. That's close enough. Okay, there we go. Super repel, throw that on. And I'll take Tom in here. Like walking around. Competitive eating! Competitive eating is one thing I'm good at. Okay. Competitive eating. Not competitive battling, though. Competitive eating. Black Belt Edward has a Scraggy. Yeah, I don't know why I kept Tom in the front spot. That was probably pretty silly. I should have went to Billy. I guess I was hoping for a Soft or something like that. But let's go to... We gotta go to someone else. We'll go to Billy, because he has... You know what? That sharp beak on Billy probably kept him from getting countered and killed. So that's pretty nice. Payback is gonna be deal double damage with Stab, because we did switch. But not too bad. We can handle that. We're gonna use Fly, super effective Stab, and Sharp Beak boosted. As it use High Jump Kick. It's gonna wreck itself with High Jump Kick. Very nice. Oh, but Scraggy dodges the attack though. Dodges the attack. We're gonna see a scary face. We know Scraggy's pretty slow. We're gonna go for a Surf to try to kill this thing, since it did damage itself with High Jump Kick. Surf's gonna take this thing out. Yes. And Billy's speed is halved, so it's kind of like he has Macho Brace on again. And he's got a throw. Okay, throw, we're gonna go to... We know throw has Bide. I probably should put Will-O-Wisp back on there. We're gonna probably use Confuse around this thing, in case it does something like Bide. And these things are about at the level that I want Tom to be fighting. You know, mid-30s is kind of where I want him to be. And Flash only has 5 PP, but we don't really care. We're gonna use Confuse Ray. It only has 5 PP because we replaced Inferno. So that's the way the PP mechanics work in this game for TMs. Which is pretty fair. This thing's gonna use a bulk up. It's gonna go for a bulk up. Does Bide even affect ghost types? Like, I'm not sure. It's confused. Let's use Hex. I don't know if confusion actually increases the damage dealt by Hex. That would have been a good thing to check here. Snaps out of confusion. Okay, bulk up. We're gonna see. Okay, that dealt pretty decent amount. We're gonna see if Hex does any less damage now. Because he snapped out of confusion, no longer confused. And yeah, it looks like confusion does not count for Hex. So I think we're gonna replace it with Shadow Ball. Yeah, we're gonna replace it with Shadow Ball. Because if it doesn't increase damage based on confusion, if it's just burn, I don't really care as much about it. So we're gonna use a little bit more powerful move. It's gonna bulk up again. This thing with +3 on both stages. We better not have a rock attack or something, but I think Tom is faster. Should be able to kill with Flame Burst. So this thing, I don't know, it looks like it's got a lot of HP. It's got counter. Okay, here we go. Here's Sock. I wish I had Will-O-Wisp. Will-O-Wisp would be really good. We're gonna use Confuse Ray. Confuse Ray first off, and then we're just gonna start spamming Flame Burst on this thing, I think. Confuse Ray. I don't know what other moves this thing might have besides fighting and normal moves. I don't know if it has... Hopefully it does not have a Rock move, because that's sort of what Girder does. Sock is confused, hits itself. And that's a pretty decent amount. We're gonna use Flame Burst. Flame Burst. Lots of damage. Very good. We're gonna use Flame Burst again. Snaps out of confusion. Bulk up. Not gonna help in killing Tom. I don't even know if it can hit Tom. Maybe he's just wasting time because he knows he can't do anything. So very good. Tom. Taking the guys out. Yeah, we're gonna switch over to Shadow Ball. And we're gonna do that right now. Or we're gonna wait. We still have 8 PP on Hex, so Yeah, but I think we're gonna go ahead and switch over to Shadow Ball. If it had double the damage or whatever with confusion, I'd probably keep Hex. But if it's just gonna be burn, then no. And oh wait, I can't put Will-O-Wisp back on there right now because we currently have Flash in that spot. I guess I could actually put switch between. Yeah, let's do that. We're gonna use Will-O-Wisp. We're gonna teach it Will-O-Wisp since Will-O-Wisp and Flash are both TMs. We're gonna replace Flash with Will-O-Wisp because we already have the Flash active, so maybe we don't have to keep Flash anymore. I don't know. We're gonna see that. Shadow Ball's like TM 30 something, right? I think it was TM 30 in previous generations. So let's scroll up here. Yeah, Shadow Ball, TM 30. We're gonna use Shadow Ball. Replace Hex with Shadow Ball, but we're still only gonna have 8 PP with it, unfortunately. We're gonna get rid of Hex. And now we're going to learn Shadow Ball, get rid of Hex. A little bit extra damage, and a better added effect. You know, if the damage is gonna be the same, because yeah, if we've been able to stack like Will-O-Wisp and Burn and have Hex deal like massive damage, then I would have liked that. But yeah, I'm not really gonna bother with it if I can't get a bonus from just confusion. So okay, that puts Tom. Yeah, we still have our brightness. We probably won't be using Will-O-Wisp too much. So if we have to, you know, switch between that and Flash to get through this cave, that's fine. That way we have better options in battle than Flash. Doll Girl Maggie has a girder. So we know from last video how much this thing can wreck our team. But we have our own girder that we can go to in the form of Jake. We're gonna expect a rock attack, probably hopefully right off the bat, instead of a bulk up predicting a switch. It's gonna use a rock slide, which isn't gonna deal too much. It's an indirect attack though, so Rocky Helmet will not activate. We could use bulk up of our own, but that might get critted through. We're gonna go for bulk up, because we should be faster. Yeah, we're gonna get a faster bulk up to reduce the damage we take and deal more damage to this thing. He's gonna bulk up as well, so we trade bulk ups. I guess that's okay. It does make us a little bit more prone to crits though, so overall I don't like that. Let's use a brick break here. I guess it's roughly the same result, I guess. But anyway, we're gonna brick break. Yeah, and it doesn't deal over half. Kind of annoying. But D punch could be pretty scary. I'm tempted to go to Tom for this last one. Yeah, bulk up again. I think we should be able to kill from there, though. I hope we can, because, like, Dynamic Punch may still rock my face. Hopefully this Brick Break will kill. Brick Break. Yeah, Brick Break's gonna take it out. Cool. Very good, because Girder is very threatening for our team. And she also has a Sock. We know that Sock has Counter, and we don't like Counter from Sock. We do not like Counter. We're gonna go to Tom, because I don't think Slot can do much of anything to Tom. We don't have fighting moves. We don't have counter and body slam. And presumably fighting moves like Brick Break. So that's not going to affect Tom. We're going to use a Will-O-Wisp on it. It's going to bulk up. We're going to negate that with a Will-O-Wisp. If it bunks up again, it'll be neutralized. Will-O-Wisp. I think that's the first time I've actually hit Will-O-Wisp. Or at least the first time I've noticed it. But anyway. A180 was pointing out that when it's a Litwick, it only has one eye, which, you know, just like Dusk Noir, who only has one eye, and I have such issues hitting with Will-O-Wisp. But anyway, we're gonna finish this thing off now with this. And using special moves means that he can't counter us, and he can't counter ghosts anyway, so because of the way stuff works. Unless that stuff was changed, which it could very well have been. Battle Girl Maggie goes down, training is over. Yeah, so you have some fighting type people in this area. However, Tom is only really good against Sox. I need Jake to take on Girder, mirror matches. And I need Billy to take on Scraggy, although other things can take on Scraggy too. Okay, here's another girl. Yeah, they only fight you when you're right up close to them, these guys do. Anyway, so there's three fighting type users here in the Wellspring Cave, bottom floor. Battle Girl, Xiao, I think is how that's pronounced. I think X becomes SH. Okay, Girder. I think we're gonna have to go straight out to the Jake to take on this mirror matchup. Blair is possible too, but I'm gonna take Jake because we're predicting a rock attack. No, it's gonna bulk up instead. Tended to go for Dynamic Punch to get some confusion on there. Yeah, let's go for Dynamic Punch. Dynamic Punch. Dynamic Punch is going to be dodged and bulked up. Very bad. Very bad. I'm going to go for it again, though. Hope we won't go 0 for 2. And we will, though. Wake up, Slap. I wish I had Sally. You know, Sally... Oh, wow. Wow. What the crap. See, if that crits now, we're in, like, a world of hurt. He's not going to use Rock. I could go to Tom, but that wouldn't really accomplish anything, so... how about Blair? Blair, how's Blair's defense compared to his... Yeah, Blair actually has better defense. Let's put... Let's see, is that gonna be okay to do? Yeah, let's go to Blair, because I can Giga Drain, and that'll get some life back, too. Yeah, Girder... We still don't have a really, like, solid, this will beat Girder no matter what answer to Girder on our team. And it's using Wake Up Slap. That dealt way more than I wanted. Let's use Giga Drain with Blair. She is significantly higher Giga Drain. Hopefully get our health back up really high. Hopefully kill it in one hit. Very good. Very good. Blair. Getting our life back. Getting our life back and killing it in one hit. So Blair looks like a pretty good option to go to take out Girder. And also has a throw. Blair can probably take this thing out, but we're going to go out to Tom. And Blair's kind of in need of leveling. She's level 44. We haven't used Blair extensively in quite a while, actually. Mostly because these last couple gems, flying and ice, she hasn't been effective against, so thus we haven't used her. We're going to put a Confuser on this thing. Just because I want to try to conserve Will-O-Wisps for things that are really threatening. And we only have like 4 PP left for Will-O-Wisp. Confuse itself. Okay, let's just Flame Burst this thing to death. Maybe throw in a Shadow Ball somewhere in there to mix up the PP usage. Welcome. I think Tom has Spell Tag, right? Yeah, he has Spell Tag, so I think Shadow Ball will deal significantly more. It's a little bit higher base power and Spell Tag, so this should kill it, I think. No, but we do get a special defense drop. Let's see if he hits himself with Confusion. No, he's not going to do that. That would have saved us having to make another hit, I guess. Yeah, we have Will-O-Wisp and Confusion. Let's just use Flame Burst. Have 7 PP on each move. Okay, so a couple of fighting types go down. A couple of Girders. Girder gave us a scare in the last part, but we know Girder is pretty slow. Who do we have leading off? Probably Billy, right? Yeah, we have Billy leading off. We're gonna put Tom back at the top. We're gonna heal up Jake, because Jake took a lot from Wake Up Slap. A lot. And so did Blair, too, but Blair was able to get Giga Drain. Giga Drain, very good move in this generation. We're going to restore Billy's health by 18 points. Blair has, like, 6 HP loss, so she can deal with that. We're going to Lemonade on our Girder for 68 health back. Cool. And next video, I seriously have to remember to buy more stuff. Why don't we have the Dowsing Machine on? Dowsing Machine, turn on, because there's probably a lot of stuff in here in caves. Yeah, up here. No, here. No. Here we go, Hyper Potion. Oh, more stuff down here. See, we should have the Dowsing Machine on. Dowsing Machine. Okay, it's actually up there. And yeah, I don't care to just spam Super Repels in here. I'm perfectly fine with that. Oh, there's an item here. Let's go ahead and pick up the visible item. Mystic Water. Okay, we're gonna put this... Actually, no, we're gonna keep that... We're gonna keep Sharp Beak on Billy, I think. But Mystic Water, I've been hoping that we would get that pretty soon. Okay, right here, where we're standing. Get a revive, another item we can just sell, pretty much. As we can't use revives in Nuzlockes. That would be, like, an interesting, easy type Nuzlocke. Where, like, you can't buy revives, but any revives that you find on the ground, you can use to revive. That would be, like, an easy type Nuzlocke for people who can't play real Nuzlocke, I guess. So... Because I know there are some people who are like, that's just stupid. Those are stupid rules. No, we're not bicycle. Because that would still give you the limited roster restriction while keeping the thing a little bit more fair. I wonder if there's like a legendary in here. Oh, there is a shaky patch up here. We're going to get this. It's going to be a drill burr, though. I think that's usually what appears here is drill burrs. Yeah, just this little mole. And it's only level 10. So we're just going to run from this thing. It's not worth wasting our 7 PP that we have left on Tom. It's also super effective to him, but it probably would not have anything at that level. Oh, there's another thing. We get a rock gem. Rock gem. Yeah, I'm considering possibly if we could find an ice gem, like an ice gemstone. I'm considering to put that on Cooper, because I'm not expecting any grass attacks on the dragon gem, and then he would have that ice gem. That I wonder if that only affects it if it hits, because that would be lame if like the ice gem, like it missed, like Blizzard missed, and then the ice gem got used up anyway. So that would be pretty lame. If there is a legendary in here, we know what we're gonna do. We're gonna try to kill it. But yeah, there's, I mean, this just seems like a place where there could be a legendary. Kind of like how Lapras... Whoa, the screen popped down, and like, I can't do this with that. Let's pull out the menu, because I have to have something. Because everything is black. I can't tell when stuff is black. Okay, there we go. Yeah, this screen is... it doesn't hold in place that well, I don't think. But hopefully it holds well enough. It would probably hold better if it was, like, at a 90-degree angle. That looks really funny. Yeah, it would probably hold better if it was at a 90-degree angle, which is what it would be for when I'm battling. So I guess that... But this LP hopefully won't have too many more parts. I'm hoping, like, 40 parts tops, which is... Oh, I forgot to put on a repel. Which is approximately, what, like, 50 hours, probably? 50 hours? I mean, we've already played 50 hours due to grind sessions and stuff. But how about that for a 50-hour... That's actually not too bad for your first playthrough, I guess. Or wait, no, because then it would be like, well, like 60 something hours real time or game time. But anyway, we need to put on another super repel. Yeah, originally I was hoping this would take like 20 parts, but eh. You know, I guess it's okay. And put on the Towsing Machine. See, I go to the menu so much in this game, and that's why the Towsing Machine gets turned off, because the Towsing Machine gets turned off when you hit a thing. And there's like arrows in the Towsing Machine, but that don't do anything. That was, what, a max elixir or something like that. So we can probably start using those PP items, because we have quite a few of them. There's nothing up here. Surfing around. Oh, there's a shaky patch up there. We're going to go back and try to get that, because I want to get gems, ice gems, if possible. I want to get some of those, so that we can maybe do that against the dragons and wreck them with the uber powerful blizzard. But we got a fighting gem. Okay. So that was a pretty large backtrack just for a gem. And also we can... Oh, there's another thing up here. We need to throw up another repel. The super repel. We still have 11 super repels left. And I want to see how much the gems sell for, too, on that guy who will buy nuggets for 10,000. Okay, and this is just the drill bar. Nothing we want to do here, let's just run away. Run away, because we don't want the EVs, and we don't really care about 20 experience at this point. Yeah, I gotta say, the circle pad is making this a lot easier to move around very smoothly, so I like the 3DS for, at least for this specific way that I'm handling the LP, and by handling I mean actually handling the DS. Oh, that was a big circle. Okay. Yeah, circle pad is very nice, very conducive to this stuff. Very good way to play some DS games on the 3DS. So, hardware improvement in that regard. Let's go up here. I think we already went up here. Repellent wears off. We're gonna just use a normal repellent. No, let's just go ahead and throw a super repel. Super repel. Do we go this way? Okay, I think this is like all. This appears to be all, I think. I don't know, maybe I missed something. Seems like there should be more. Like, I was expecting, you know, a little, at least one more floor. There's just some, like, fighting users down here. That was, like, it. I was expecting maybe, like, okay, there's a way to come over there. Let's go ahead and jump. Oh, we already went over that way, right? There was a Pokeball. Or, you know, an item. Oh, that's nice. We stumble upon a fighting gym. I wonder if there's fighting gyms in here because of the fighting users. Anyway. That appears to be it for the Wellspring Cave. Not a whole lot in here. I don't know. There could still be something that I just missed. You know, or maybe there's a legendary at some point in there after you beat the game, because they usually like to stick legendaries in like random places. And there's these cliffs here are clearly meant to help you get out quicker. Wubat. Yeah, we still don't know what Wubat gives. A180 confirmed for me that Roggenrola does give defense, so I wasn't crazy in that regard. Shadow Ball in. Okay, so next place. Next place we're gonna go is someplace where we can catch something. I don't want to do Mistralton Cave this video, because I kind of need to get a move on and go places and end this part, like, pretty soon, actually. I'm trying to think of, like, a quick place we can go. Let's just go to Nimbasa City, because I kind of need to leave and go to school to do some things, like, in the next, like, 20 minutes or so. So, let's just go. This team, since I was confident enough in it to take out those fighting types before, I'm confident enough that it can handle some athletes. So we're going to battle some athletes. And as a result of this... Or wait, no, never mind. This will be Saturday's video, I think. Saturday, April 2nd's video. It'll be uploaded theoretically today. Theoretically, assuming things process properly. And I'm probably going to have to run to school on Sunday. But anyway, you guys don't care, especially if you're watching this long after the fact. So, let's go in here. I know sometimes, like maybe it's sometimes during the day, you can't battle people because they're like just practicing or something. Okay, there's some fans here. Two people on the sideline, so we can probably battle them. I forget exactly what the tennis people usually have, but we have everyone with their proper items. Oh yeah, Tom has the Eviolite, because we think he can evolve again. Okay, so he did not have the spell tag then. That's why they didn't kill earlier. As a proper lady, I'm elegant all the way down to my toes. I like proper ladies who are elegant. Smasher Elena. Smasher Elena has a Zebstrika. We know how Cooper feels about Zebstrikas. Do not like. And not just because of the kill card either. We don't have Justin to go to. We can't go to anyone else, really. We're gonna leave Tom in. I don't think Zebstrika has Crunch. We're gonna use Will-O-Wisp anyway, because it likes to use special attacks. That made perfect sense. Will-O-Wisp. At least Will-O-Wisp hits, so it'll be damage per turn. Let's see how much damage that discharge did. It did 120. That's 87. Did 33. So we can likely that's 26. I didn't need to do a times two though. So we can live a critical hit discharge, and we have it messed up now too. Okay, we're gonna see another discharge. It's gonna hit. Confuse Ray is gonna hit too. We're gonna heal up Tom and use confusion and burn to just deal damage over time and bias turns, pretty much. Because I don't have Justin to come in here and just smack this thing around. We need a lemonade, because Tom has lost quite a bit of health. Actually, I wanted to make sure we did a calculation there and make sure we can live a critical hit discharge. Tom restored back to full. The Striker uses discharge again. And yeah, it's going to take three, or more than three. Yeah, because that does about 33 damage to us. I think it did exactly 33 again. Let's use a Shadow Ball on it. It's a little bit stronger than Flame Burst. I don't know if this thing is a different type besides pure electric or not. Shadow Ball comes, and it has not hit itself with confusion yet. Burn's gonna take it out though. Burn's gonna finish it off. We're gonna have to switch out Tom. Hopefully a pursuit user does not come in because Tom is weak. Okay, levels up. Again, okay. Some gains. Okay, that was her only guy, never mind. Oh crap, I forgot to put the amulet coin on. That's kind of the point. Dang. Well, who knows though, that Aviolite may have saved Tom's life. Or, you know, maybe not saved his life, but made it easier on me. Let's put Blair at the top, then. I'm gonna put Blair at the top, and we're gonna give her the amulet coin. I forgot to do that. That's, like, the whole point of battling these guys, is so that I can get money. And, sort of messed that up. Okay. Miracle Seed replaced with that. Blair should be pretty okay. We're gonna use a... In case we need Tom for something. We're gonna use... Why is fresh water, like, so far down? Okay, we need to have fresh water close to the top. And same goes for lemonade. Put lemonade. No, don't switch packets. This bag. This bag is like in the bottom tier of bags, I think. It's in the lower tier of bags in Pokemon games. Anyway. I guess it's still better than the first gen bag. If only because it does have some form of pockets, but Anyway, Diamond and Pearl bat. Well, no, Diamond and Pearl bag is still pretty bad. I don't know, just because of the way items were all in the same pocket, it would be, you know, I mean, they bothered in this bag. They bothered to, you know, have, you know, little icons for Pokeballs and for held items, like for the Icy Rock, which, by the way, we need to go pick up another rock, and Scope Lens and things like that. You know, they put the little floppy disk symbol by them, like they're held items, but they don't give them their own pocket? What's up with that? Anyway. That would have been really nice. And they took away the Pokeball pocket. Seriously. Smasher Aspen has a Whimsicott. So grass versus grass matchup. Is this thing like grass? I wonder if this thing is like grass flying. I'm not sure though. So we're gonna go. We will go to Tom for this thing. So it's a good thing we healed him up. We ended up to need him. Whimsicott. I was just watching an episode. Yeah, here comes a gust. I was afraid this thing may have some flying moves. I was just watching an episode of Ghostager last night, and there was a. What was the thing called? Palabra? It was some like rhyming name, like remember Palabra, and like the first part sort of rhyme with Palabra or something. Anyway, it was like a big fluffy white monster. I wonder if that's what that's partially based on. Here comes the Lilligant. We're going to quickly flame burst this thing before it starts doing dumb crap like that. Lilligant is annoying. Please no, don't hit yourself. Okay, you know what, we're gonna throw a Will-O-Wisp on here because I want to throw out some dots. For more dots. More dots now. Don't see enough dots. More dots now. Come on. Will-O-Wisp. Will-O-Wisp and hit. Thank you. Good job. Okay, we're just gonna stand here until this thing dies. Because we can stand here until it dies. I think this thing has Mega Drain. Which kinda makes me want to go to Blair. Yeah, we're gonna go to Blair. Because Blair should be able to outspeed and help it along on its path to being dead. Teeter dance. Except for the way she keeps predicting freaking switches. So annoying. But she doesn't have Stealth Rock up or anything like that. So we're just gonna let our burn on her killer gradually. We're gonna heal up Tom off screen. Quiver dance. Yeah, this thing rather annoying. At least it's not using Swagger, it's just Teeter Dance. We're gonna go ahead and stay in the Blair one turn. Or are we? No, we're gonna use... No, because he'll just predict the switch and use Quiver Dance again. Or, not Quiver Dance, but, you know. We're gonna use Leaf Blade. Teeter Dance. See Teeter Dance. And this thing is actually faster than Blair. So this thing is pretty fast. If it's faster than Blair, and that's four levels lower, this thing must have really... Oh, no, never mind. I'm dumb. It's just because of Quiver Dance. Quiver Dance, that's right. Okay, so now we get some good money. Get some money. And I think that's probably... Usually there's only, like, two guys. Usually the ones out here do not battle you. Wait, it's what? Something profound about it, yeah. Here's a youngster. Can we battle him? No. Oh, yeah. He's a ball boy, so he's practicing for stuff. Oh, tennis are wonderful. Okay, here's a double battle. Do we want to do a double battle? Let's put our two aces at the top here. Jason and Cooper. And we have Blair. Actually, let's put Blair at the top as well as Jason. No, let's not do that. That'd be bad. Let's put Cooper at the top, because that way, if they have, like, fire guys, they don't have to switch out both. Okay, here we go. These are, fans, right? Or backers, as I believe they're called. Yeah, backers. Joe and Ross. Yeah, they have two Zebstrika. That's what I was afraid of. Which is, kind of bad, but you know what? I think Cooper and Blair should be able to outspeed these things. We're gonna use Aqua Jet. We're gonna reduce the amount of enemies available on the field right now. And I think that either one of them can live either. Oh crap! I forgot about Discharge though. That may be really bad. Hopefully they went for Flame Charge on Blair. But at the same time, Cooper's like 11 levels higher. He should be able to take it. He has a lot of health. Discharge. Oh, Discharge is everyone. What am I thinking? Cooper lived this. Yeah, okay, Cooper. Oh, I like how it said that. Yeah, it was super effective on Cooper. It was not very effective on Blair. Okay, we're gonna switch Cooper out because he did get paralyzed. Otherwise, I would just Aqua Jet and do that. We're gonna go to We don't really have anyone who's good to go to. We're just gonna heal Cooper up then. Or wait, let's see how much that did. See if we even need to get a heal up. 37. Yeah, that only did 37 damage because of Solid Rock. Yeah, so 74 would be a crit. So Cooper's pretty fine. I think Cooper's fine. We're just gonna Aqua Jet. Aqua Jet and Leaf Blade. And Leaf Blade may just kill it anyway because Blair's awesome. Or maybe not, because Leaf Blade only did that, Aqua Jet only did that much. Leaf Blade finishes me off. Very good. Yeah, Aqua Jet mitigating the paralysis there. Blair, level up to 45. Any moves? No moves. Her moveset's pretty okay, though. Okay, they actually have a decent amount of money. That's 37. That's not too bad. That's half as much as we're getting from the athletes. So I want to go battle those other athletes, and then we're going to get a gym. Or not a gym, another icy rock or whatever from that girl. And yeah, today's Friday. But I need to be getting a move on. Cause that's stuff to do. Besides Pokemon, I know that's crazy to, I know that sounds crazy, but I have things to do besides play Pokemon. Kinda wish that wasn't the case sometimes, but well. Let's go to the big stadium, right? Small court and big stadium. I guess that, yeah, small court because it's basketball. Yeah, you have a basketball court and a tennis court. Then you have a football stadium and a baseball stadium, right? So that makes sense. Good job naming things. Let's see what we're going to have in here. There's some mowers going outside if you guys can hear this crap. Striker. You guys hear this? It's like a lawnmower or something right outside my window. Kind of annoying. Okay. Anyway, we have Cooper, Blair. We're gonna put Blair at the top because she has the amulet coin, and that's kind of why we're battling these guys. Just so we can get money. Why do we want money? We want money because money buys us stat items. Pokemon 11. Yeah, there's 11 people on a soccer team, right? Soccer is like officially, I think, my favorite sport, even though I like never watch it. So, there's a Swanna. We're super effective to half of its typing, but not the other. So we're not going to stand here with Blair. We can go to our own Swanna, who's only one level higher, by the way. But let's go to Jason, because we know Jason just evolved, and it's probably going to use a flying attack, which Jason will resist. And then we can. And Jason's actually not that slow. Tailwind. So it would definitely be faster now. It probably would be faster anyway. Just because I think it's pretty fast. And so setting up Tailwind, setting up Rain Dance. So we're going to see Discharge, likely one-shot this thing. Jason, I think, has Bright Powder, is that right? I think that's what he has. His stuff kind of stopped there when stuff was dying. So that was the only thing he had. Yeah, 8200, very good. Let's fight the other guy. Here's another guy who's not currently playing. And then we have some backers up here, too, we can probably fight. So yeah, these guys, we probably need to come every real-life day that we fight, which doesn't correspond to every part, since sometimes I do multiple parts in a day. But every real-life day, I need to remember to come back here. Obviously, only when I'm on camera. You know, I'm not going to play off-camera. Because you saw what happened last video against an athlete. I almost freaking died. A Leaf Blade is going to one-hit KO this life hard because Blair is too good. And that's the only guy he had. Cool. More money. Lots of money. Each one of those is almost a free... or almost comes up to the amount of a stand-up item, vitamin. Because we're going to fight some backers, double battle, cheerleaders! They have two Swannas, which I think is what I remember them having from last time. And we're going to send out Blair and Cooper. We're going to use Smackdown with Cooper, and we're going to switch Blair out to Jason as Cooper lays the Smackdown on one of these Swannas. Go Jason! I want Jason level 50 at some point, too. But I'm fine with Cooper being a highest level guy. Yeah, we used a couple of Zinks on Jason to improve his special defense, so he's taking the hits pretty well. And we know that Cooper has at least 100... Well, Cooper either has max EVs or has 100 special defense EVs or more by now. So, one of those two things. I'm guessing it's just that... we have to use Charge Beam on this thing because we can't use Discharge because it'll hit Cooper. So, yeah, double Zeb Striker with Discharge. Oh man, that's really annoying. Because we know that I think they actually have another ability besides motor drive, which is kind of neat to have multiple abilities, because then they don't know whether or not the electric move is ineffective, and you're not going to risk it. I mean, it'd be not be effective anyway. But, you know, it's just nice to have that, and just to make sure that the opponent thinks that they can't hit you with an electric move, or, you know, caution them against using an electric move, even if you have the other ability. Which I think the other ability may be something useless, like Lightning Rod. So, I don't know. Then again, Lightning Rod, if it is Lightning Rod increases your special attack, right? So, in this generation it does. So, we got Lightning Rod and Discharge. I don't know if that's... Or Lightning Rod and, other thing. I don't know. Anyway. By the way, I wonder if Lightning Rod, if it doesn't affect you. Like, for example, if you had Rhyperior and you wanted to make, like, a special attacking Rhyperior, kind of like Palmer and Diamond, I wonder if you could do, like, double battles and Discharge and hit your Rhyperior that has Lightning Rod instead of Solid Rock for some reason, and increase its special attack, even though the attack didn't deal any damage. So, I gotta say, though, that's a very nice thing for Electrike, or not Electrike, Manectric. Nice improvement for a Manectric with Lightning Rod. It gives it some use in single battles. As far as I know, you still take the damage, but, you know, you resist it, so it's not as big a deal. And, no, we can't go down there. Okay, we're gonna go and get... We're gonna go through here a little bit. Probably next video is gonna be more of us... More of... Whatever. More of the thing. Okay, and the deep water is still frozen. So we have to... A little bit more annoying to get around here in the winter. You know, it just turned winter this video. I don't know what triggered it to become winter, but it did become winter. So, winter it is now. I wonder if we can, like, even get places. No, the one person I'm looking for is way over on this side. I'm looking for... Looking for this person. Yeah, she gave us... Like a heat rock. We got a heat rock. I'm guessing it's based on time of day, which one you get. She promises that she'll be here tomorrow. Okay, so... What are we gonna do? Well, we know that next video is gonna start with another grind session, right? So, probably some more auto grinding, getting some guys up around level 45. Maybe what we do... I know I want Jason level 50. I want both of our guys level 50. Cooper and Jason for the Dragon Gym. We're pretty much almost there. And Jason evolved again, too, which is really good. We're definitely going to be using him. I may also get some more Zinks and stuff. Actually, let's go do that right now. Go get some more Zinks, maybe, to use on Jason. I don't think Jason maxed out his special defense, because I'm a little bit afraid of dragons having, like, Flamethrower, and I want Jason to be able to live one of those. Do we have an Akaberry? Do we have an Akaberry? I want to think we have some Akaberries. Akaberry. Yeah, we have two Akaberries. Oh, that's right, because I wanted one for Blair. Yeah, so we'll put that on Jason to guard against Flamethrower and stuff on his weaker defense. So we'll probably have that on Jason for the gym, or at least for the gym leader, Iris. Let's go and get some more Zinks, though. Some more Zinks, because we're almost level 50, so we'll see a direct improvement. And we've fought some guys, so let's get some Zinks. Let's get four Zinks. That'll put us about back to where we were. And we're going to see what Jason's special defense is right now. Jason has 95 special defense. We're going to see if this gets him up pretty close to 100. With a couple of Zinks, if he can even use all these. Right here at the top, because we used all of ours last time. Okay, Jason was able to use all four, so he probably has pretty close to 100, if not exactly 100. Or wouldn't be exactly 100, because I'm sure he's gained some here and there. And yeah, he does have 100 special defense now. Very good. So Jason, starting to sort of replace Aaron as our best mixed tank, just due to resistances. So very good. Very good. And Aaron we probably need to level up to, because I still like her a little bit better than Gerda. She takes special hits better, which, you know, we want to make sure that we can take everything from everyone is the idealism. But yeah, we actually didn't catch any guys this part. We were going to, but, yeah, they're not exploring any really new areas where we can catch guys, so... And I would go on and make this part a little bit longer, but we've had about, what, an hour? So, yeah, I guess that's probably about an hour and 20 minutes or so, so I'm gonna guess the guess that the total video time will be, because I know that grind session was pretty long. But we're gonna heal up, and we're gonna save that for next part. I'm gonna go do some things at school and upload some videos and stuff. We're gonna save. Yeah, I'm starting to get behind. There's a slight possibility that there will not be a video up Sunday, but I think hopefully there will be, because I'm probably just gonna drive into school, and especially just to upload whatever I do tonight and a couple more nights in the future. Okay, so we're gonna be grinding up some other people in the next video. I will see you guys there, and there's a possibility that part 31 is also gonna be a grinding video slash exploring. Just depends, because I don't know. We may go into the gym in next part and see kind of what's going on in there, what levels they have. And since my voice is apparently dying, later days.